Hello everyone, this is Nitpicky Nerd, and I just rewatched the Voyager episode Unity. I mostly was following up some possible contradictions with the new Picard show, because Hugh said that the Romulans on that Borg artifact were the only Romulans ever assimilated to his knowledge. And in a later episode they even said that every Borg remembers every other Borg, which by the way I think is ridiculous. Because there are trillions of Borg in the galaxy, how can they possibly remember every other Borg? So I thought that's a bad line. Maybe I could buy that they all remember Locutus, because he was not an ordinary Borg drone. Instead, he was something special, kind of like a new version of the Borg Queen. We also know that he was not fully assimilated. He retained some of his individuality. Basically, the Borg were trying out a new tactic and preserve some of his memory and personality in order to try to convince humanity to not resist. And or to give them a tactical advantage, because he will know all the strategy of Starfleet. So that's why I can buy that all the Borg know who Locutus is, but it's hard to buy that every single drone remembers every other drone and would recognize him. So I wanted to check if Hugh's line actually is a continuity contradiction, because he says that the Romulans he has in that facility are the only Romulans who ever were assimilated according to his knowledge, and that means up until the point in which he was freed from the collective. So I rewatched the episode Unity and I found even more mistakes. However, I do think they can be explained away. It's a little bit convoluted, but it can be explained, and so it's not technically a mistake. And I'm going to offer a theory to try to explain all of these contradictions. And first of all, it's important to note that all of Hugh's memories from the Borg Collective is only up until the point when he was freed from the Collective, which I presume happened a short time after the episode I, Borg, in which he returned to his ship. And because the Borg didn't know that he was compromised, they didn't erase his memory, they hooked him up back to the collective of that ship, and his sense of individuality spread to all the other Borg drones on that ship. I'm guessing that was the ship we saw later in Descent, that was Hugh's ship. So it somehow caused chaos on that ship and probably disconnected it with the bigger collective, and so Hugh's memories from the bigger collective were only up until that point. So we can say that that Romulan we saw in Voyager was assimilated after all of that, and that's why Hugh didn't know about him when he said that these are the only Romulans who were ever assimilated. Which I still think is kind of a stupid line, simply because, you know, the collective is vast, so how come so few Romulans were ever assimilated? You know, the Borg were attacking Romulan outposts even back in season 1 of TNG, and so it makes no sense that there are so few Romulan Borg. But maybe it's due to the fact that, again, Hugh doesn't know every single drone who was ever assimilated. So it would be too many people across the whole galaxy. So that's why I think his line is not a huge mistake. But when I rewatched the episode Unity, I actually found a whole lot more problems of continuity. For example, that human woman in the episode said that she was assimilated at Wolf 359. And that immediately begs the question, how the hell did she survive when that cube blew up in the end of that episode? So how is she even still alive? So the only explanation is that she was either transported out of the cube using some kind of long-range transporter, and the Borg didn't yet have that long-range transporter that we saw in the Picard show, but maybe they had something else, something not as advanced, but some other way to transport off the ship, and maybe that's how the Queen survived, because she said that she was on that cube. And one of the theories to explain that was simply to say that there are multiple Borg Queens, maybe on every single ship, and that's why she didn't die. But I never liked the idea of the Borg Queen being present on that cube that was destroyed by Data, who hacked it through Locutus, because how come the Queen couldn't prevent that from happening? She could cut off drones from the collective. We saw the Queen had that ability later in Voyager, and Data was able to put all the Borg to sleep. It's kind of hard to believe that if the Queen was on that ship at the time, that would be possible. And that's why I prefer the explanation that the Queen somehow left that cube before it attacked the solar system. Maybe she was still on it during Wolf 359, but after that she saw that Locutus is doing well, and so she left him in charge and left the cube to go somewhere else. So she could either beam herself out using some kind of advanced transporter, maybe taking some Borg drones with her, or living on a smaller ship like the Borg Sphere that we saw in First Contact. Maybe the older Borg cube also had some kind of secondary vessel coming from inside it, and so maybe the Borg took some of the newly assimilated Borg drones, including that woman, and left the cube before it went into the solar system, leaving Locutus in charge. And that can explain why that woman was later in the Delta Quadrant, despite being assimilated at Wolf 359. And as for the Romulan, I guess he was assimilated sometime after Hugh was freed from the collective, or simply Hugh doesn't remember him because he doesn't remember every single Borg drone in the galaxy. So let's say that woman was put onto another cube, which then went back to the Beta Quadrant and assimilated the Romulan ship or a colony, and that's where that Romulan came from. And so after that, they were together on the same cube. And later that Borg cube disconnected from the main collective because of some natural disaster. And that's how they both ended up on that planet that we saw in Unity. And so because it can be explained away and it's not too far-fetched, it is a bit convoluted, but it's not so far-fetched to be impossible. That's why I don't really consider it a mistake if it can be explained, but it's still kind of a sign that people are not paying attention and creating unnecessary problems in the writing process. But at least we can kind of tie it all together and to also explain what happened to the Borg Queen. Why wasn't she there at Earth when Locutus was being hacked into? Why didn't she disconnect him? And so we have kind of another bit of evidence that some of the Borg on that ship must have left the ship before it went into the solar system. And so the Borg Queen probably was with them and left the cube at the hands of Locutus. And I'm guessing she was probably pissed off at that event because the Borg are not used to losing, and so that can explain her obsession to finish the job later and to return personally and to even use time travel, which normally probably they wouldn't want to use, to defeat humanity at all costs. And one of the problems in First Contact, and this has been discussed by many people, including myself many times, but the main question in the beginning of that movie is how come the Borg didn't use the time travel before they reached Earth? They could have done that at a big distance without anybody knowing and then approach Earth in the past, then there would be no resistance. So why didn't they? And one of my commentators actually offered a brilliant theory to try to explain it, by tying the time travel method to an episode of Deep Space Nine called Past Tense in Season 3, which was before the movie. And in that episode, they discovered there was some sort of singularity near Earth, which caused that accidental time travel. And because of some chroniton particles, which got embedded in the hull of the Defiant, it also protected it from the changes of the timeline. So that's very similar to how the Enterprise E got protected from the changes. And so the theory is that maybe the Borg detected that singularity and were able to use it to open that time vortex, which they wouldn't be able to do otherwise. So the Borg are not so advanced to be able to do this anywhere, anytime, but instead they exploited that phenomenon which was only near Earth, and that's why they could only do it after they reached Earth. It can also explain how was the Enterprise E able to return to the future, since they didn't have whatever technology the Borg used to do that, and yet they were still able to do it. So that also implies that it was tied to some sort of natural phenomenon, and maybe they scanned the Borg ship when it did it, and that's how they knew how to reopen that vortex using that same singularity. Just like in the episode Past Tense in Deep Space Nine, they were able to use it to jump across centuries, several times in fact, and so it can explain how the time travel worked in First Contact. And this specific technique of time travel wouldn't be possible at a bigger distance from Earth, and so that nicely explains why the Borg had to fight through all of Starfleet before they did that. So I really love that idea and how well it ties to Deep Space Nine. So that's the theory I will stick to if anyone ever asks me this question again. So that's all I wanted to say about it for today. Let me know what you think in the comments below and we can discuss it in the comment section. And I will see you all next time. Bye bye.